Relaxing out here. The backyard's so stunning.
It's beautiful.
Sarah Kickert and Selfie Design, I'm telling you, and Len Bush.
I know. Full of flowers.
Can't beat it. Thank you to Jake Zebarth. Okay, Barbara posted this photo of what looks like a worm. I saw it all over the place. It's freaking me out, but you're telling me that this is a nice snake?
It's the northern red-bellied snake. It's a small little snake. You would like this one.
No, I don't like any.
It's very good. It eats insects. It eats slugs. So if you see it, this is not one to get rid of. Keep this snake around. It's a good little cute snake. I'll bring you one.
Don't you dare. But my question is, so are snakes still being born, or are they born in the spring? Can you still have a pile of baby snakes coming out of your foundation or something?
I think that was maybe a baby. No, that's its size.
You're kidding.
No, that's why you'd like it.
Okay, no, I wouldn't. I don't even like worms. Okay, Libby wants to know what this bug is, well, and she's finding it all over her flowers.
Yeah, it's that time. It's a Japanese beetle.
No.
On it, you can really tell if it's the real beetle, the Japanese beetle. Look on the edge, you'll see little white bumps like this, sort of like a little crown on the side, but they're out. You could spray them, you could knock them off. The only thing I'm telling you is do not use one of those traps. It attracts more beetles to your yard than it gets rid of. So
the pheromone tracks.
Yep, they're here now.
Okay, all right, just pick them off. They're easy to pick
off. Squirt them off even.
Or just use soap and water. Yep. It's pretty easy. Okay, Polly wants to know what these pods are from pods are and how they formed on her purple bearded iris.
Yeah, well, she also wanted to know if she could use them for seed. It's really pretty difficult when you have either an iris or a lily that has those pods. It takes a long time for them to bloom. Again, it's gardening. If you'd like to try, let them dry out, open them up, spread them on the ground about an inch apart, cover them with a little soil and see what happens. But it's going to take some time. It's not a quick deal.
And what was the bug?
What bug?
That was a pod, not a bug. Sorry, my fault. Okay, that's Kelly wants to know what is going on with her dogwood. It is goopy and sticky.
Yeah, it's cool.
Oh,
That's lots of mealybugs. That's what she's got.
No.
So mealybugs, again, neem oil works great. Spraying them with soapy water, that works great. There are chemicals if you choose to go that way, but make sure you do it. You mix up only enough to use and spray it. And spray it in at nighttime so you don't kill any of the pollinators. But
Good luck.
Got gooey, sticky mealybugs.
Sorry.
That's okay.
All right, we're going to go to gorgeous Elk River. We have a question coming in from Pat. We have a 20-foot maple tree that was injured by another tree when it fell down. It now has a shoot coming out of the base of the tree. Should we cut the main injured part of the tree off at the ground level, a maple?
Well, it's kind of hard to tell without a picture how much of that tree was injured. If you cut it off at the ground level, I won't be alive by the time that tree grows up. I mean, you got little tiny things. It's going to take 20 years or so for that tree to look like something. So what I would do is maybe get your city arborist or even pay for somebody to come and see if you can save the mass of the tree that's out there. So without a picture, I can't really tell you whether to chop that tree down, but I'm always not in favor of chopping a tree down.
And if you call your township, your city,
yeah, they have
an arborist, they can pop by and give you some free advice. So do that if you don't want to pay someone, but it's a really good idea when you have trees which are worth so much to get the right advice.
Yep.
Okay, our last question is not a question, it's a comment.
Oh.
Hi, Bobby and Blinda, my family and I just returned from France and England this week and want to thank you for your advice about the Monet Gardens. Bob, we visited the gardens and we were amazed at the beauty of this area of France. Thanks for the tip, Mark Knudsen from beautiful Harris, Minnesota. Thank you, Mark. That's
Paris
a nice
rhymes com- with Paris.
Yes.
It was outstanding. Monet's garden, it was just so, so beautiful. I could have spent 2 days there just sitting in it, man.
Let's go back.
We should.
I'd love to go there with you.
Let's go.
I've never been.
We'll leave everybody else.
And I'm glad you went. Thank you for the comment. We really do appreciate that. All right.